IRS, so may I help you?
Yes, sir. This is Paul Grailman. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing great. Listen, what I was calling for, I'm going to be in India working next summer, and I was wondering if I could get a job there at the call center.
Oh, you want to call to India?
Yeah, I want a job there at the call center. I want to be the IRS, and I know the script real well. You want me to show you?
So you are Indian?
No, I'm an American, but I'm going to be in India.
Oh, okay.
And I would like a job at the call center.
But I don't think they have a call center.
Well, I know the script real well. You want me to show you?
I mean, I'm saying I don't think the India they have a call center.
Oh yeah, they have a bunch of them.
No more.
No more. No more. Let me show you how good I am. You act like you're calling the IRS, and I thank you for calling the IRS. This is Officer John Smith. How may I help you?
What?
How may I help you?
I don't know.
Do you want to pay your taxes?
Okay. Can you say that again?
Yes. This is the IRS.
Yeah, can you say from the beginning?
Okay, all right. We'll start again. Okay. Thank you for calling the IRS. This is Officer John Smith. How can I help you?
Nice one.
Sir, can I have your name and your address, and I will look up, I will pull your file, and I can give you more information.
Nice one.
What is your name?
John Smith.
John Smith? Okay. Hang on just a second. I'll let you listen to some music while I pull your file, okay? Okay, Mr. Smith, are you there?
Yep.
Okay, do you have a pen and a paper with you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I want you to write down my name, okay? My name is Officer John Smith.
Mm-hmm.
And my badge number is IRM.
Mm-hmm.
OU812.
Okay.
And your case ID number is BR549. Could you read that back to me, please?
BO549.
Okay, and what was my badge number?
771.
No, my badge number was IRMOU812.
Okay, OU812.
Okay, I have your file here, Mr. Smith, with the information in front of me. And the reason you got a call from the IRS today is that between the years of 2011 through 2016, you have paid your taxes every year just like a good citizen, but you have had some miscalculations on your WD-40 form. And therefore, that's why this phone call is in order. Are you aware that a warrant has been issued for your arrest?
Okay.
And Mr. Smith, you owe a total of $5,914.24.
Okay.
Do you do your taxes yourself, or do you have an accountant that does them for you?
Okay.
Who does your taxes?
I do it myself.
You do them yourself, okay. Well, you have made some bad miscalculations, and I have to tell you, I'm required to tell you that this phone call is being recorded by the Homeland Security and by the Internal Revenue Service and your local sheriff's department. So please be truthful in all of your answers, okay?
All right.
Okay, Mr. Smith, do you have a car?
I'm sorry?
Do you have a car?
Car,
yes. Automobile.
Yep.
Okay, I need you to get in your car, and I'm going to need you to go to one of the government-affiliated stores to get a tax voucher, an electronic federal tax voucher. And this,
all right,
this can be attained at one of the government-certified stores, such as Walmart or Target.
All right.
Which one would be closer to you?
Walmart.
How long would it take you to get there?
Well, probably 5 minutes.
Okay. Do you have a credit card or cash that you can pay the debt to the IRS?
Yep, I have a cash.
You have it in cash. Do you have the cash in the bank or there at home with you?
I have a cash with you, Mike, with me.
With you, okay. What I need you to do is to get your cash, a pen and a paper, and your car keys, a form of identification, and let me know when you're in your car.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'm ready.
Okay. I need you to start driving toward Walmart. How long will it take you to get there?
Five minutes.
Okay. Do not disconnect this line. If you disconnect this line at any time, your arrest warrant will be activated and put into the process mode, and within 45 minutes, the police will be at your doorstep to arrest you and put you behind the bars, and you will serve a minimum of 17 years, and this is an unbailable offense. You will not be able to bail out.
Okay.
Now, if you choose, you can fight this matter in the Goat House in Washington, D.C., but if you lose the case, you will have to pay the government $90,000. So do you want to fight it in the Goat House, or do you want to pay the fine?
Yep, I want to pay.
Okay, head toward Walmart. Let me know when you're in the parking lot.
Mm-hmm, I'm rich.
Okay.
I'm rich. I'm in the Walmart.
Okay. Sir, how did I do? Did I do a good job?
That's a nice one.
Okay. Can you get me a job there in the call center?
Oh, okay.
And he is gone. Oh, well. I thought I did a pretty good interview. What did y'all think? I wish he would have stayed on the line and told me how I did. I was eager to know. Oh, well. Oh, and listen, guys, if you scam baiters, if you guys call the IRS and you happen to get a IRS agent that sounds like he's from the deep south, just try to take it a little bit easy on him, because it could be a new guy. You never know, I'm just saying. Thanks, guys.